This aquatic wonder can be best described as completely unbothered. It takes its time, gliding leisurely through the waves and occasionally even sunbathing on the surface. Predators can tear chunks out of it, and it just keeps on keeping on. It doesn't even have a bone to pick with the fact that its status as biggest bony fish has been recently toppled by a close relative. This is the sunfish. Hi, I'm Danielle Dufault, and you're watching Animalogic. The ocean sunfish, otherwise known as the Mola, is the second largest bony fish in the seas. But coming in second doesn't mean that the species isn't preposterously massive. Sunfishes can easily reach a ton in weight, but the heaviest on record was over 2 tons and was an almost perfect circle at 3.3 meters in diameter. Yep, it's round as a silver dollar, but about 100 times bigger, as heavy as a large giraffe. Until recently, the sunfish was believed to be the absolute biggest bony fish in the world. That record was upset by the discovery of a specimen of Mola alexandrinae, also known as the bumphead sunfish, which weighed more than 2,700 kilograms. Along with ocean sunfish, this species is one of the 5 extant species of the Molidae family. It makes sense that the word mola comes from the Latin for millstone, which perfectly describes these mega-heavy, disc-like fish. Despite looking like a bunch of ancient artifacts, this group is actually among the youngest in the ocean. They made their grand appearance in the seas about 50 million years later than most other modern fish. Sunfish are known for their iconic, derpy appearance. They have bulging heads, big, vacant eyes, and 4 beak-like teeth that can't quite meet, giving them the look of a forever mouth breather. But the teeth that really matter for the sunfish are in their pharyngeal jaws, located in their throats. Pharyngeal teeth have evolved independently in many species of bony fish and are used for food capture and separating wanted from unwanted food. In the case of the sunfish, their pharyngeal teeth are used to trap and swallow the jellyfish that make up a large portion of their diet. Whatever particles the sunfish doesn't want to eat are then jetted out of its mouth. It can also use this jet force to defend itself from predators and even propel itself to make a super slow escape. Being large doesn't always mean you're slow in the animal kingdom. If you don't believe me, just try and outrun a hippo. But in the case of this underwater giant, the sunfish's enormous size does really make it seem like it's swimming through molasses. Its top speed is a breakneck 3 kilometers an hour. Unlike other fish, but have tails formed from the caudal fin that acts like a propeller to push the fish through the water. Sunfish have a pseudotail that steers more like a rudder. Called the clavus, this pseudotail doesn't grow alongside the rest of the fish, which gives the sunfish its round shape. To propel itself through the water, the sunfish flaps its exaggerated back and belly fins like wings. This is similar to the flapping motion of these same fins in its cousins, the puffer and porcupine fish. Sunfish can be found lolling about the globe in tropical and temperate waters, though they can tolerate temperatures as low as 2 degrees Celsius. So in theory, they could be anywhere, other than the Arctic and Antarctic oceans. If they get chilly, sunfish simply float to the surface, lay on their sides, and soak up some rays. If you didn't pick up on it by now, that's why they are nicknamed sunfish. Laying on their sides on the surface actually serves more than one purpose. Their big, slimy bodies can be home to over 40 types of parasites. So by floating on the surface, they invite seabirds to snack on the creepy crawlies that cover their skin. To prevent their eyes from being plucked out by indiscriminate seagulls, the sunfish is equipped with a specialized muscle that allows them to pull their eyes deep inside their sockets. Hey everyone, we have exciting news! We're thrilled to announce the release of Animalogic's very first book, Strange Creatures. This book dives into the most incredible animals we've ever featured on the show, with each chapter packed with my illustrations and stunning full-color images. It's a fun and engaging way to learn about the animal kingdom, and a perfect tool to spark kids' interest in science. Each chapter breaks down an animal's biology, behavior, and all the coolest facts you need to know about these fascinating creatures. Animalogic Strange Creatures is a must-have addition to your own library, or the perfect gift for an animal lover this upcoming holiday season.
Click the link in the description to check it out, and if you can, order a copy. It would mean the world. Thank you so much, and I hope that you love the book.
When being groomed by overzealous seabirds, some of the flesh will inevitably come away with the parasite. But that doesn't seem to bother the sunfish too much at all. Apparently, they aren't even too fussed when predators take a bigger bite either. Tis but a scratch. Their large size and very thick skin keeps most would-be predators at bay. But sunfish are still occasionally preyed upon by sharks, orcas, and sea lions. When they tire of their twisted little games, the sea lions will abandon the sunfish to sink to the bottom and die. Mammals, why are we always such jerks? It may come as no surprise that one of the greatest threats to adult sunfish is another mammal, Homo sapiens. Boat propellers and rudders can easily kill a floating mola, and drift gill nets can damage their skin and protective mucus layer and fill their gills with air. Plastic bags, too, are especially dangerous for molas because the floating bag can be mistaken for a delicious jellyfish. Once ingested, the bag can easily choke the mola or clog its stomach, preventing it from being able to eat. Despite the fact that these surface-loving giants are easy to spot, the research on sunfish isn't actually that extensive. We don't know, for example, how fast they grow, or how long they live in the wild. Because they live out in the vast open ocean, we're also still trying to grasp the size of their populations around the world, and even where they spawn. We do know that females will lay up to 300 million eggs every breeding season. The babies start their lives as tiny larvae, less than half a centimeter in size. But how they manage to survive to the behemoths we find gliding through the ocean is still an alluring mystery. So what should we talk about next? Please let me know in the comments and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later.